Hi folks! So in an earlier video I showed you how to download this point data from the Atlas Archéologique de la Tunisie, and that's what we've got displaying here in this window at the moment. Okay, in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to install the OpenLayers plugin for QGIS so that you can get satellite imagery and other sorts of map underlays available to get working with this data set. To install a plugin, you're going to need to go to the plugins tab up here in the top and click that. And then we're going to need to choose this first option, manage and install plugins. Okay, so click that and then you get this window appearing. And then in order to filter this huge list of available plugins, here we need to type into this search box. So in order to find the OpenLayers plugin, we'll type OpenL. And then we can see it's the third option here in the filtered list. So if we click that, then we can choose from this button here in the bottom right, install plugin, and click that. Okay, so and then that will take a few moments for the program to install the plugin. And you might see alarming messages like not responding there, but don't worry about that because then you get eventually plugin installed successfully popping up. And then we can close this window. And then under the web tab in the main QGIS window, we'll see then this OpenLayers menu, which wasn't there before. And in there you have different options to look at, to import layers from OpenStreetMap, Google Maps, Bing Maps, and various other sources. So I'm just going to show you quickly an example of importing the Google Satellite imagery layer. So left click on that. Just click away the error message which comes up, and then you'll see that we've got this Google Satellite layer in our layers panel, and that's appearing in our map window. You might find that if you import it, it comes in at the top here, and then it would be, of course, it'd be over the top of your other layers and any other data that you want to see. So in order to avoid that, you'll want to move it to below your point data layer somewhere. Okay, so let's zoom in on this for a second. Now, you might find sometimes when you're scrolling around that you get a distortion between where you think your sites in the atlas should really be and where the satellite image is lining up with them. This can sometimes be a problem of your coordinate system. So, for example, if you'd set the map coordinate system to WGS 1984 with an EPSG of 4326, you might see some slight problems with where the points are appearing until you zoom in. In order to avoid that, you'll probably find it best to work with this pseudo Mercator with the EPSG of 3857, which tends to avoid that, and the points appear more or less where they should be at the different zooming levels. Okay, so that's just something to remember when you're working with your point data and working with satellite imagery layers from Google. Okay, that's all for now, folks. Thanks for listening.